Idiski Times, now available in stores around the country for only R3.50.
It is TV powered by World Sports Betting. SuperSport United 1, Kaizer Chiefs 2. It's getting better and better in terms of the results, at least for Stuart Baxter. Last time I checked, Omar Chaka had a note. It was a list of demands that he wanted from Baxter. Aribona and Tate Baxter, if this thing doesn't change and it doesn't improve, we're going to have to take action. Well, it's improving, at least in the results. Not in the gameplay, but at least in the results. How do you feel about the game tonight? Or even before we go to the game as well, I have to say that, number one, yesterday was a funeral of the late striker, the Kaizer Chiefs, Ulrike Maselesele. And Machaka was one of the people that was there with Amatola Funerals. And they did a great job. You could see the videos. They provided the family with a lot of support as well. Just take us through your involvement with the family and how was the event yesterday, the funeral?
Yeah, Nkulux, firstly, a good morning to Tom Pilapeng.
Yes, sir.
Ka smile. I don't know if that's a smile. Good morning to Machita. Elwana Nkulux.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Nkulux, indeed, it will be unprofessional and also unjust of me not to talk about what really transpired yesterday. Firstly, let me acknowledge the presence of Amatola Funerals, yeah. The presence of CEO Mr. Nala, all the way from KZN coming here to give support as well to Lucky Romario Maselesele, his family.
Sure.
So, Nkulux, also let me acknowledge as well the team from Amatola, especially team from Newcastle, also team from Dundee as well, Tabile, Sticks, Skotani, and Mklengi. Thanks very much for coming as well, to give moral support to the family of Maselesele as well. And also the Johannesburg team as well, Nkulux. I was there myself, Dijana was there, Zweli was there as well, and Tando, and together with Leseo as well. They were all there, even Bema as well, even Ulindo as well. Guys, thanks very much for coming through to help Maselesele's family. Nkulux, it was touching when we heard about the passing of Romario. It was, we did support him as well. You know, while he was still playing, I was there, Nkulux. Yeah. He found us, you know, supporting Kaizer Chiefs, and he came through and he did make his mark, especially on the field of play. I remember scoring a goal against Orlando Pirates. Remember when you score a goal against Orlando Pirates? I mean, it's a derby. who'll ever forget it, yeah. Nkulux? So, Nkulux, yes, gratitude to the family as well of Lucky Maselesele's family, just to allow Amatola Funerals to save the nation. By not the word of mouth, through action,
yeah.
You could just see, you know, what really transpired. Thank you very much as well. And people who came as well, legends, I saw some legends as yeah. Well, came through. My man Piri was there, Temba Mguni, and others as well. And even Players Union were there as well. And Chiefs and Paris branches as well. Thanks very much for coming. The family, I did speak to them as well after the funeral. I went back there with Dijan, and we did have a chat. And Nkulux, they were very, very impressed with what Amatola Funerals did. Mm-hmm. Indeed, they saved the nation, Nkulux. And thanks very much to the family. And thanks very much for whoever came to yesterday just to come and offer help, assist the family wherever he can. Thank you very much.
I was impressed. And we were saying, even everyone in the room, would you look the job that Amatola Funerals and yourself as well, spearheading that, that was impressive because he belonged to a team, he belonged to a nation, he belonged to a country, but for Amatola Funerals to chip in there, it was very impressive what I saw. Anyways, moving into the game then, it's a win, it's 2-1, but I just cannot get over the last 20 minutes of that match. And also, maybe, okay, because this is your video, really. I just need to hear your opinions about the win. Is it a step in the right direction? What are the players that impressed you?
Absolutely, Nkulux. Congratulations to the Klama Boys, sure. Kaizer Chiefs that we really support. Whether it's sunny, or it's hot, or it's rainy day, we're always there, Nkulux. So congratulations to them as well, you know, getting 3 points away from home at Lucas Modipe Stadium,
yeah.
Against number two. I was even surprised, or are we playing against the number two team, SuperSport? You know, how did they get there? Is this the team that, because before I came in, I said to myself, are we going to get it? Are we going to get 3 points, yeah. Or a throw?
Yeah.
Because by looking at the stats, saying SuperSport is number two behind Mamelodi Sundowns. It means they've been doing very well coming into this game. But Ngulusi, what I saw that I don't think they deserve to be there. So we played Ngulusi all the time. You know that if you have a player like Dolly, you know, and even Billiard as well, and even Parker, congratulations, my brother, you came to the party, Ngulusi. You know, and the team as a whole, they played as a unit. But I can tell you, first half, I can't say it was a fireworks in the first half.
Yeah.
You know, to me it was a dull game, all in all. But the most important thing to Parkstar, you can even see he was talking to himself. I don't know, he was talking to what, giving instructions to himself. So it is a wake-up call to say, indeed, you've got to put the Glamour Boys where they belong, at the top. So Ngulusi, to coach Parkstar, yes, at the moment, yes, he keeps on grinding those points that we needed so much, just to put the confidence amongst the players as well. So as you know, we've been doing well before he came as well. So Ngulusi, I'm happy about, you know, 3 points, but the performance, we still need to improve there and there, you know, in terms of, especially in the middle of the park, where we don't normally play. We play from the back to Dolly and to Billiard. That's where they do the miracles, or the machine. Kama and Billiard, come and Billiard. Can even see Hugo Bros is there. I don't know why he didn't write something when Dolly's got the ball. Whenever he's got the ball, he must write something. Whenever he passed the ball, so that we know that next time, call up Dolly's there, my brother.
All right. Let's have a look at last question then. Some of the improvement areas, obviously, Ungobo, they keep on playing him at number six as a defensive midfield. And you can see when he's on the ball that he doesn't really know what to do with it because naturally he's a defender. Anthony Agay, from the first time that we ever saw him, there were questions, and there will continue to be questions. It's not a hate thing, it's not personal, it's about Kaizer Chiefs being Kaizer Chiefs. That's a big club.
Absolutely.
That's a big club. That's really, Kaizer Chiefs are a big deal for every Tom, Dick and Jerry to play there in that midfield, especially on Ngomasha or Dr. Kumalo, Gerald Sibeko, all the players that have played Kula number six. But anyways, I digress. Some of the improvement areas in that midfield, what would you be doing when in your position? You have Nange, Cole is not there. Would you be toying around with the idea of Abo Bakas, Abo Ngobo in that midfield instead of again on Ngobo, who is a defender?
Absolutely. As I've said before, Ngobo should be brought back to where he belongs. You know, he's a defender of the season once again.
Yeah.
We must keep on saying that to Pakta so that it sink into his head as well. So Ngulusi, I think Ngobo should go back there from defense. And number two as well, Ngobo should be playing, and even Olukuzana, Upakas as well. So I don't see, yes, again, Ngulusi, I don't know what he's bringing into the team. Yes, he did score some crucial goals sometimes back. but in terms of the ball, you can even see even he's got the ball. He doesn't know where to pass the ball. But a player like Ngo, when he's got the ball, he knows where to put the ball. It's like Dolly. So players like Ngo and even Parkers and also even Sohota, I don't know where Khadev is. These are the players that Stuart Parkers should look into to say, guys, no, let's bring these guys. Let's put more confidence in them. Let's give them support so that they can be able to help Dolly and Billiard going forward. But all in all, it's Pakta selection and Ngulusi. Let's see what happens going forward with the Baxter selection. But all in all, I would love to see Ngobo coming back. I would love to see Parkers getting more time. I'd like to see Sehota and even Khadebe coming back to give that moral boost to Pilat and what do you call? To Parker as well is back.
But he got off injured, though.
Yeah, absolutely. It's been a recovery to him.
Yeah.
Let's hope he's not that bad. He'll come back in the next game against Stellenbosch. Mm. So Ngulusi, so far so good for us.
Yeah.
So far so good for us. We can't complain that much, but we just keep on growing Ngulusi, making sure that we salvage our position, especially at the top. We need to be there with Sundowns, my brother. SuperSport should move down. It must go up, my brother.
All right. well done, Kaizer Chiefs. There you are, then. As a new match, sometimes 3 goals scored, but you're still not satisfied with the kind of football that you saw, the kind of entertainment value that it brought, especially knowing that on the other side, in Manchester City or Manchester United, they'd be showing off 6-0. It's like, yo, you wish you were on the other side watching entertainment, Mo Salah being the best player in the world at the moment. You know, but here we are. We have to watch these games with you and bring you an analysis. It is Kitivi, it is Kitimes, and World Sports Betting. Thank you very much for watching us.